happy to talk to you about necrotic enteritis in chickens in this topic. Difficulty for farmers, especially medium-sized farmers or beginners. So currently, how many diseases are there that cause watery stools and diarrhea in chickens? Each disease has different reasons and treatments. So, how does necrotic enteritis differ from other diseases? Firstly, let's learn about the epidemic of necrotic enteritis. This disease is caused by Clostridium bacteria. Clostridium is an anaerobic bacteria, or can be understood simply as Clostridium will grow and works well without oxygen. This means that if your barn is dark, humid, and poorly ventilated, this bacteria will grow well. This disease does not happen regularly and is not common, but once it is caught, it is quite difficult to handle. The damage depends very much on the speed of treatment. When the disease occurs, it must be treated quickly and accurately on the guidelines to minimize the damage. Secondly, the time of year necrotic enteritis occurs. It is the time of changing seasons from autumn to winter, because this is the time when chickens are often stressed. You need to pay attention to temperature changes, limiting draft in order to limit the occurrence of diseases. Thirdly, reasons of disease. There are many different reasons, but there are the following three main reasons. The first one is hygiene. If you leave the barn dirty, dark, the chicken's feeding troughs dirty, necrotic enteritis is very common. To overcome this situation, you should pay attention to clean, increase ventilation and light for the barn. Farmers should use litter products to handle barn fillers, which will also contribute to minimize the risk of necrotizing enterocolitis for chickens. The second reason is nutrition. You should pay attention to follow the process when you change the type of chicken feed to reduce stress, and also need to care about choosing the type of bran and food having guaranteed quality, which will limit disease. The third common and important one is the secondary cause from other diseases. There are two main diseases that are very easy to develop next to necrotic enteritis, which are coccidiosis and E. coli disease, the top of which is coccidiosis. To limit this, when detecting that your chickens have coccidiosis, you need to focus on treating them quickly and decisively too. Fourthly, which stage do chickens usually get sick? Usually chickens get sick most during 3 to 8 weeks of age. This does not mean that older chickens do not get sick, but it will be limited, less occurs. Fifthly, is the mortality rate high when infected with necrotic enteritis? You should know chickens with necrotic enteritis usually occur in acute form. Chickens die at a high rate and quickly. The carcass is still fat. This causes many of you to mistake it for pasteurolysis. Regarding the specific mortality rate of the disease, many documents publish 50%, but in fact, with the advanced level of husbandry techniques, the mortality rate usually falls to 8 to 10% or 15%. However, if subjective and poorly handled, the mortality rate can be up to 50%. The next item is diagnosis you need based on external symptoms such as moodiness, anorexia, chicken stools having a lot of water, thin, especially foamy. The stool color is diverse and has no specific color. Observing this outward manifestation is difficult to accurately diagnose. To be more precise, you should have a surgery. Here we will guide you in detail. Because chickens have diarrhea, dehydration leads to more difficult peeling skin than usual. Next, you should focus on observing the chicken intestines. The intestines swell. The intestinal wall you can see is very thin. When you cut it out, you can see the fluid in the intestines. This is a point that you can't see in any other disease. However, when diagnosing the disease. You also need to pay attention to the differential diagnosis of necrotic enteritis with coccidiosis. If farmer can't tell the difference, get a coccidiosis drug to treat necrotic enteritis so the chickens will be tired. Spend money on medicine, the disease may not be cured or take a long time to heal. On the contrary, if you use necrotic enteritis drug to treat coccidiosis, the disease will definitely not be cured. So, what is the difference between the two diseases? The first is about feces. Necrotic enteritis has loose stools. Foam and coccidiosis's stools are usually bloody in the form of feces. Especially in the liver. Liver of necrotic enteritis is swollen. Yellow or white, while coccidiosis shows almost nothing. The intestines of chickens with necrotic enteritis are swollen and contain a lot of gas. The wall is thin. While the intestines of chickens with coccidiosis are not swollen, there is a lot of blood inside and there is almost no gas. In terms of treatment, here are some treatment regimens. Regimen 1, combine injection and oral administration for herds. If having severe symptoms, inject for 2 days and give oral for 3 days. About injectable drugs, you can choose Intertrim of Interchemi or Somatrian JVB Pharma. But please note that, catching chickens gently. Don't make them fly. This can cause chickens to die very quickly. During the injection process, you mix tonics including Good Body, GCKC, and digestive enzymes too. Pump the chickens to increase their strength. After 2 days of injection, seeing that the chickens are more agile, you switch to a drink regimen to reduce human effort. You can use 100 grams AmproWS mixed with 100 grams Damoxin together and used for 1 ton of chicken. You can combine with tonics and oral antibiotics. According to the schedule, in the morning take antibiotics and in the afternoon you give tonics. The second regimen, you can use it in a situation where the chickens are lighter or have just discovered the disease. You use 100 milliliters of Intertrim for 180 oral, mixed with 100 grams of Damoxin WS to use for 1 ton of chicken in each morning, at noon and afternoon. You use a formula of energy booster including GCKC, Good Body, and Chicotic. Regimen 3 is also a drink regimen for your reference. You use 100 grams of Ampricoc WS mixed with 100 grams of Biosilin to 100 WS to use for 1 ton of chicken in the morning, at noon, and in the afternoon. You use an energy boosting formula, including GCKC, Good Body, and Chicotic. Please note that Biosilin 200 WS is amoxicillin 20%. You can also use drugs with 50% concentration according to the manufacturer's recommended. With the above three regimens, you can cure the disease in 5 to 7 days. But in the next 10 to 15 days, you should continue to use Kinetic liver and kidney detoxification products combined with Chicotic enzyme in dose. 200 milliliters Kinetic combined with 200 grams Chicotic to use for 1 ton of chicken. As you know, chickens with necrotic enteritis, the liver is severely affected, so Kinetic will help eliminate toxins from the liver and kidneys. Finally, about prevention. You can base on the three causes of the disease to have effective prevention methods, such as periodic cleaning of the farm, ensuring ventilation, using products to treat the floor of the cage, and spraying disinfectants periodically. About antibiotics for regular use, you can use Intertrim for 1800 oral or Damoxin WS. We hope the video will bring you useful information. Goodbye and see you again the next topic.